IP winning the second game rather handedly. Really good drafting as well as really solid play from pretty much everybody on KaiP. What was your favorite part about last game, Purge? Because I know you've really enjoyed the series so far, so...
God, it's not even the digital game one, it's just how deliberate and how organized their movements have been. It feels like watching people that truly, truly understand the game of Dota and... are each piece is like moving very effectively, and it's very surprising because this is just like a qualifier, right? Like it's a bit different than watching. You see this stuff at like high levels of majors usually, but I'm just really respecting a lot what KP's been doing here, or KP's been doing here in terms of their map movement. That's been the most impressive part for me.
I feel like the addition of Pilot Die helps that a lot, for sure. I think what he brings to the table is pretty top tier, because obviously he's been on some very good teams. I mean, Secret being the best. He's won a major with that squad. So Pilot Die coming back and playing with this squad, or at least standing in, I should say, is giving them a lot to work with, I feel like, Purge.
Yeah, it really is, and everything's changing up every single game. Like Sand King over Magi opening for Escape gives them a really strong early game. They're a little afraid of Bambo getting that again. KaiP gets a Kunkka in exchange with a Morana. They're kind of trading some of the same heroes back and forth, but it is also going different ways and becoming a little bit more diverse sometimes. So it's pretty fun to watch.
Yeah, I mean, these games have been back and forth. There was that 10-minute period near the Tigger game, I think it was, where there wasn't very, very much action happening, but that was really the only downtime when it's come to fighting and just cool Dota happening. So, with this Beastmaster pickup, KaiP are going to... I think this is the first game in this series. They picked up the Kunkka. It's been Yapzor played for both games so far. And similarly for Escape, I don't think they picked the Sand King first game. I could be wrong about that, though.
They did not. There was no Sand King game one. Game two, there was. And it was quite effective, I think. Bambo got a ton done. His KDA looked poor, but I think the impact that he had was very, very high, and he eventually transitioned to great farming as well. Like, he had bad KDA, but he still got, like, a 13-minute support blink dagger. That's amazing. It's definitely impressive. So, yeah, it was very effective. Escape's gonna have to try to use it better. A lot of people have been playing it more as a core in some matchups, do like Sand King versus another offlaner 1v1. But support is still effective if you can play it effectively, and KaiP is going for the stun strategy. They've got really good disables right now. Kunkka, Morana, Beastmaster is an insane rotation of disables.
Yeah, I mean, you got the Roar into Arrow, Torrent into Arrow, X Marks into the Torrent into Arrow, although it's a little bit more difficult to hit than, say, something like a Nightmare. You obviously have a lot of options here. You have a lot of options in laning. Escape go for the Slark, something we haven't seen from these teams, not too often anyway. The Slark will be picked up and Escape Gaming will grab it. We'll see where they go with it, right? Rather.
I like the Slark. It's a pretty good solution against this. I remember watching a game in... Manila C qualifiers where at the time, who was it? TNC actually was, I believe, playing against this other team. I don't remember which team it was, but they're having a lot of trouble with Beastmaster at the time, because that was when Beastmaster Jungle first started getting really popular for him so fast.
I remember.
And they actually drafted a Slark against it, and it worked out amazing because Dark Pact, obviously, if you prep or anticipate the stuns from landing, Slark just super hard counters. So despite KaiP having so many disables right now, if Slark just gets Dark Pact off once, Escape should be able to take team fights. I would kind of like them to grab something like a Bane here, maybe. I would normally say SD, but SD is gone. Bane, they already have two supports, so that's the problem. But they need something, ideally, like a Glimmer Cape, maybe, that can keep somebody alive if they do get chain initiated. Whether that's Slark or somebody else.
You know,
Glimmer's a huge priority.
We casted a lot of those Manila games during the Manila qualifier games, excuse me, for the SEA region. I feel like that was the one game we didn't cast with each other. So it's kind of funny that you mentioned that. Also that the Slark pickup is coming up for Escape Gaming, but the Anti-Mage comes out for KaiP. I want to get your thoughts on that pick in particular and what Escape have to do to deal with the Anti-Mage as we move forward, as Ricky is a very good choice against it, I feel like.
I mean, AM's a really good pick for the fact that Beastmaster, Moron, and Kunkka are very individualistic. They can just run around the map as a group and make a ton of stuff happen. If Anti-Mage is off somewhere else farming, and those three plus their last hero are getting kills or taking team fights, then Anti-Mage should be getting out of control. To mention the fact that Escape is mostly magic damage, Slark, Ogre Magi, Sand King, all magic there. Ricky does provide some issues against that due to Smoke Cloud preventing the blink, but at least until they get something like Orchid, like, it's anti-mage just actually just not threatened by the first three heroes that were picked. Slark should never really deal with AM, and in a lot of late game situations, if Slark's stunned for 2 seconds or more, sometimes Manta plus ultimate just kills him. So I really like the AM pick. It's absolutely appropriate this game. The Ricky roaming as well can be very effective. Just because it should help shut down Morana in lane a lot. I don't know who's going to lane against Morana, but a Smoke Cloud plus whoever the mid hero is. It could even be like Slark. I don't think I would want to lane Slark against Morana ever, but Ogre plus Ricky roaming in with the smoke maybe, plus the mid hero, that's pretty easy kill setup. So I think Ricky was a great pick also. It's also very good against Beastmaster, just because you're invisible, so he won't know where you are while scouting with Hawk, unless there's also a gem in the area or some sentries.
Out of curiosity, I don't think it was muted a second ago. Have I been muted this entire time?
I don't think so. You just didn't respond that one time. I think you forgot to push to your push-to-talkers thing. That's why. I started talking again.
I have no idea how that mic got muted.
From my side, you weren't talking, so I was like, all right, Mott's putting food in his mouth or taking a drink or something. So
no, it just, I think my the push-to-talk thing that I was telling you about in TeamSpeak got screwed up.
Yeah,
but
I remember.
We'll move on. Things happen.
Was it awkward? What was it like from your end? Because yours is the production feed that went up, so it's probably awkward for everybody.
No.
Were you saying something like really smart and I just told you to shut up essentially?
No, not at all. It seemed we were, as funny as it sounds, we were riffing back and forth. It's just that you didn't know that we were riffing, and I don't think the stream knew either. So
okay,
that's
nice.
Okay.
Perfect. Legion Commander is a pretty good pick here for Escape. It's kind of like a panic, like we have to do this pick because they just don't have enough anti-mage lockdown, at least until Slark gets like Basher. I mean, with Ogre, Sand King, and Ricky, that alone can be enough, but it's iffy and it requires all three heroes. By grabbing Legion, they now have two heroes that can kind of be anywhere and combo with the other heroes on their team and set up a guaranteed kill on AM. So they have to kind of grab Legion here. But even with that, it's actually a really good Legion game. And this is one of the downsides of the AM pick, actually. It's so interesting. It's very similar to Slark Dark Pact in that, remember before I was saying like Bane, Shadow Demon, get something like that. Legion does that with Press the Attack. You can remove stuns from people. So while it also counters the anti-mage, it is also going to remove the stuns from people that get chain stunned. It's such a cool pick here. And for once, I'm actually fully behind this Legion. It's always the most successful hero, but the fact that it covers two of those weaknesses is amazing. And it was such the perfect pick.
You've swayed me. You were. It sounded like you were really backing Kai P for a while with the draft that they have. Obviously, Kai P, if you had to pick their fifth hero, which obviously is very important, but Escape, you know, they look a lot better now with that Legion Commander pick, and I'm one to agree with you. I like the Riki roaming. I think Riki is also a good counter to Anti-Mage. I think Slark, although if you do a 1v1 with like Slark versus Anti-Mage, Slark doesn't really win that 9 times out of 10 with Manta style from the Anti-Mage and a Mana Void coming through, but it depends on how slippery this Slark can be, how many Essence Shift stacks he can steal, and just...
Depends how far he gets ahead, basically.
Right.
By the time he finishes something like Silver Edge, for example, all they need to do is kill AM in the first like 5 seconds, drop his spell shield away, and then hit him with some nukes and die. So I think Escape definitely picked the right two heroes to deal with what Kaipe opened with. Now Kaipe has to do the same back. Now they're more worried about defensive things. If somebody gets dueled, how are they going to save him other than just chain stunning the Legion? That's kind of their only solution right now, and that's why things have gotten quite weird for them. In a lot of cases,
they still only have room for another support here, I think. So that, assuming Morana goes mid, Beastmaster goes offlane, so they could do something defensive or more offensive.
Go for AA. Very good against Slark because you can Ice Blast him through his ultimate, and then he doesn't regen during that. So this is maybe not the best counter to Legion necessarily, but it's very effective against Slark, and it's a great tri-lane effectiveness hero too, just because Cold Feet is so fantastic. So Kunkka plus AA plus a third hero, it guarantees they can land three Cold Feet, or I'm sorry, Chilling Touch attacks. So their tri-lane's very strong, and it will give them better mid-game fight.
Wait, see how things start coming up here for both of these squads as we get into game number 3. When it's all said and done, Purge, give me your honest opinion on this draft for both squads. Who do you think's coming out on top of game number 3?
I'm not quite sure, actually. One thing to be said is Kaipe has way better high ground heroes. Beastmaster as well as Anti-Mage, but they definitely have some good AM solutions with the Legion Ricky. So it all kind of comes down to how well the early game goes and then how the mid game progresses in terms of team fights. It's execution. It's an execution game.
We're going to find out how these lanes are set up as we get into a pause. Yes.
Hey, Mott, have we talked about gambling yet?
We have not. That's a good point. Well, guys, if you're interested in gambling, make sure you guys check out Betway.com. You can use the promo code over on the side of the screen. I can just hover it over it here. Of course, use the promo code there to get the free €5 bet. And make sure you guys are 18 years of age and older to be eligible. Of course, Betway is, of course, a licensed and legal gambling site, betting site as well. So make sure you guys check out Betway.com. And make sure you're 18 years or older, as well as in a country where gambling and betting is legal. So definitely check that out.
Yeah. But in case Mont didn't oversell that, don't gamble if you're under 18. That shit's addicting.
Please.
But if you're an adult and you're responsible about it, there's nothing wrong with it.
Usually for people, and this isn't necessarily a problem for people in America, but I know people in other countries. Actually, there are plenty of gambling addicts in America, but they're too busy doing handicapping and
slot machines.
Yeah,
I know one. Charlie Ying, William Lee.
Oh my god, I actually became
Manila Mont.
Yeah, I became
shitloads of money in Manila.
Yeah, there's a story about us gambling that I'm not going to delve into right now, but maybe sometime later in the future.
Let's just say that Mont got a couple blackjacks. That's all.
A few double downs as well.
With this said, though, I also like to point out that a lot of people also lost money. So it's
you
hear the good stories most of the time. But I'm conservative. I lost like dollars.
Okay.
Three sessions, so it really wasn't that bad.
You know what? I'm not gonna say it.
We should stop here. Let's move on. Let's talk about Dota.
It's a bad impression, but I say what I was gonna say. The App Store puts that award down towards the enemy jungle, towards that hard camp
blocks
on the side lane. It's in the spawn box, so as you said, blocks the camp. And Bambo will go ahead and block. Looks like he kind of missed it a little bit, so I think Sing Sing's block is gonna be a bit worse than that of Limp, although it might be a little bit close.
It'll be fine.
That's pretty close, yeah.
So the camping blocked is pretty huge. Beastmaster didn't go Iron Talon, so he's going to have to walk all the way to his jungle to guarantee that he gets neutral camps if he does get zoned here properly. And Ogre should be able to do that.
Sing, by the way, brought the salve from base to Sing Sing. Or rather, excuse me, Bambo brought the salve to Sing Sing just to make sure he got it and the courier wasn't stopped. You have to take these precautions whether it's a Riki or Bounty Hunter in the game. So some things to keep in mind. And, we'll keep an eye on mid.
Very careful about when he chooses to right-click.
Bambo?
Okay, X will save him, no problem.
That was a sick arrow, but it's just not enough damage at level 1, unfortunately.
Yeah, if Riki wasn't there, they might have been able to get that kill, in all honesty, but...
That's what he's there for. Anti-Mage getting free farm. Lane is, of course, being just completely... It's gone. Kezu's just decided to go to the jungle with Caustic Finale and an Iron Talon for now. So the way this is shaping up is that the Anti-Mage will get free farm. They might move down there at some point, but for now, he's getting free farm, and that means that the Ancient Apparition is allowed to pull and grab experience as well.
And this is what every support should basically do. Do a small camp pull, connect with the large camp, and once you do that, you're getting... Look at this, he's already level 2.5 right now, and it's only 1:40 into the game. You should do this almost every game. Biggest pet peeve, learn how to pull through, guys. Riki does block the camp, though. That's messing things up heavily.
I will say that pulling through, especially the new pull through, it's not the most difficult thing in the world. If you knew how to pull through before,
it's harder. It's definitely harder. Way harder than it used to be. Well, he blocked both camps, too. The Epsilon committing a sentry and an observer ward to that one. They actually have sentries everywhere. What the hell? They put one to check a rune, it looks like, and then they put one down to check for the offlane ward. Bone 7 looking for the obs. It's actually not there. Now they know it's blocked. On the bright side, Pi did get the pulls, and he got a decent amount of the last hit, so he could buy another pair of sentries, which I think they need to do now. Assuming both camps are blocked. The important thing about what Yapster did is that it's going to heavily delay Pilei Dai's levels, because every time he does that pull through, he got a huge amount of experience. The faster you get the 6 on AA, the faster you can start coordinating ganks around the map and getting an advantage. So I think he kind of needs to deward those camps.
But really he bought big. Dust. If he instead just saved it for another set of sentries. I don't know if he bought the dust right out the gate. I don't think he did. But
what dust are you talking about?
The Kunkka dust?
Click on, no, I'm talking Bambo. About sentry from Pilei Dai.
Okay, yeah, okay, he has 200 gold. Okay, I mixed my heroes up there for a second, but yeah, you're right.
Yeah, the other really important thing is that because both these camps are blocked, they just can never control the wave, which means that Yapster is going to be able to just sit in the offlane and get experience. Normally, when you're playing Riki, you don't get that much EXP. You kind of slowly drag it out and eventually catch up, but now they're just screwed. These two supports are going to be really under-leveled due to this. This late rotation into ward blocking was just really smart by Yapster here. Instead, he didn't even do that around, instead of playing around mid. Like, the meta about Ricky is you normally go mid, and there's, like, a sentry there, and you have to deal with playing sentry versus sentry combat. But instead, he just completely gimped both supports and the carry by doing this while giving himself experience.
Yeah, this is a very... And it's not just Yapstra that's doing well either for Escape Game. It's really everybody. Slark is now... So we talked about how the bottom lane was getting free farm. Now it's top lane that's getting free farm for this Slark. Not only that, mid's doing pretty well, but hold that thought as Limp is going to get caught by a Cold Feet, a Starstorm proc of two, and Dambo getting the right clicks to get Freeze Blood with the X marks coming through. So, as I talk about the LC doing well in the mid lane, the Caster's Curse comes to fruition, and
yeah,
she goes down.
And that's what happens when supports can't do anything. Then they're like, well, I guess I might as well gank, and then they go gank, and then they get a kill. So, technically, Limp needed to play very safe during that time period because he should have anticipated. Oh, Beast might die here.
Oh, the salve. Well, is he canceled? I thought he could have gotten the kill. The salve maybe didn't come out, but you saw the right click damage with the level 1 tricks of the or cloak and dagger, excuse me.
It's pretty weak, but he might have been able to get it. Are we going to see a Bambo kill here?
Bambo's getting caught. There's going to be a couple right clicks. He's going to get cold feet of the body blocks. Oh, he doesn't get cold feet. It doesn't lag. Bambo still might be in trouble. Dark Pack does hit him. Cancels the clarity. He has to head home. And Era, it looks like he will be able to just get out. Still to level 6.
30 HP left on him mid. Not able to get the kill just yet, and Legion's not quite 6, which is the big thing. Till Legion hits 6, his disable is pretty weak.
And always the leap is available, except for now, with just on cooldown for 15 seconds, so they have to be wary of that. They're overwhelming odds, there's no creeps nearby, so Sing Sing will be able to just take minimal amounts of damage from that.
Vision, they can build this, I think.
Oh,
and
they have Vision.
6, though.
They have the Orb of Venom slow, and Limp, he doesn't have any more movement speed to be able to get close enough. Meanwhile, TP in from Bambo. They have the duel available. The X marks will go. Limp has got to press the attack if need be. The arrow will come out. He can't do it on himself if he's arrowed. There's the smoke screen. Sing Sing. He's going to leap away for the time being. Limp is still taking plenty of damage. There's the press the attack, taking tower hits as well. And
so
Bambo
many.
Might get this last right click. The tower will try to bring him down low. The torrent, is it going to do the job? No, it will not. Oh, Bambo is so close to getting that kill with the torrent, but it's going to be the neutrals that secure the kill.
That was next level plays back and forth, both players there. Really well done. They might be able to catch the Ricky, though. Doesn't have a blink. He needs 8 mana.
They have the dust. Yeah, he's
going to
go down. They had the dust. And even though the Cloak and Dagger was ready to go, the dust just came out, and it was perfect timing. Deny coming out from Kezu onto that tier 1 tower, so no free tower for the anti-mage, but still up to 41 CS in 6 minutes and a tower deny. Pretty good start for an anti-mage.
He's pretty happy, but look at Sand King. He's got 35 CS of his own. He's also farming amazingly. Pretty crazy game so far, but 2 kills eking out for Kaipi. Gold advantage is moderate. It's about 1,000 for escape, but it's not out of control. Support levels are a big deal too. Level 4 and AA. Bamble's going to pull him back with X.
Ah, that's such a good ability. God, that's actually...
Did he buy his own bottle? Oh no, it's Sing's bottle, I see. Oh, that was cool. So they put the bottle in the AA. He went back to buy items. Refill the bottle, and they pulled him back with X. That's value. And they immediately go for smoke. That's what's really cool about this, is that they're efficient about getting back to Fountain and back again, and now they're able to instantly turn it into a gank. If they can get a kill with this, it's going to be harder for Escape to realize that it was coming. Except for the fact that they're staying on a ward the whole time. It might be obvious.
Yeah, it could be. That Observer ward might have spotted it out, that one like you were talking about in the mid lane.
Quite clear that it did.
Yeah, look at where Sindarin is right now. There is no tier 1 tower, though. And cold feet, ice vortex. No cold feet there, just the ice vortex was used. Meanwhile, Riki continues to scout out 3-3, cloak and dagger, but there is a... Oh, it's a Dire Observer War, not Radiant. I thought it was Radiant for a moment.
Yeah, he placed this while he's invis, too. It's such a nice thing that Riki can do that.
That's
while he's
like
invisible now.
One of the most ridiculous aspects about Riki is that he doesn't have to come out of invis to place his, ward.
Kezu can get nuked here just before he kills all the neutrals too. I feel so bad. Okay,
he
gets one at least.
And he's
but...
gonna give the other one though away, and as well as the smaller Hellbear away to the KP side.
Good delay there. It's like 150 gold or something like that. Mm-hmm. Sindarin getting good levels here in the meantime, which is nice for him, but be a little worried about dying. I might have to land the torrent from Skillshot, and with the time happening now, it's very difficult.
Yeah, the experience going the way of Escape at this point. Level 4 Kunkka, Burrow Strike, this is going to be your first duel and more than likely a victory, and it will be going the way of Limp, but I feel like he could have gotten at least one duel earlier than that.
It's hard, man. But with those camps being blocked, there was always three heroes mid, and it really limited Legion's ability to accelerate. It is very, very important that he does get a lot of duels off, because that's Legion's problem normally. He usually gets to the mid game or the late game, and he just doesn't scale well as a carry. He needs a lot of duel damage for it to be justified, because he has to buy so many defensive items due to the nature of duel, making you defenseless.
Man, when did the Slark get 75 CS? It seems like it came out of nowhere. I thought the anti-mage was on top, but...
Basically, nothing has happened in the top lane for a long time, so that's why I'm sleep farm. They might kill AA here. This looks
and
really strange.
Pylai die, or are they going to go on to Kezu? Maybe he's going to be the one to go down. He is mana void for the anti-mage, but they won't go any further. They'll drop a couple of sentries down. It looks like they spotted out Yapzor. Torrent, wrong direction. Good guess, but... It's not the right direction, unfortunately. And Yapzor is able to walk away. Urn and Toe, by the way. I do like the Urn pickup for Yapzor. This is really good.
It does 150 pure damage. So when he's in these early game situations and he doesn't contribute that much to fights, that extra damage boost can really change everything.
He's slight just going to keep regen. Shadowing.
It's just cool. I like it. They have to die for it to be good. Oh, very good against AIM as well, actually. It's one of the best items to buy against AIM because he normally has magic resistance. Easy way to kill him.
Urn being pure. When did that change that?
It's always been like that. Well, it used to be HP. What was it? HP loss or something? HP removal it used to be.
Yeah, yeah.
But as soon as they removed HP removal, it became pure, which is why it now interrupts Blink Dagger. It's been a while.
Is there anything that's still like that, like HP removal? I think the old rupture was for a bit. I think they might have changed that.
They might kill Ricky here. Get the rough. No, he's barely out of range. No, he gets
roar. They find it. Yeah, an ice vortex on top of cold field on top. Excuse me. I want to get my A's, but I was confused for some reason.
False mistake or a small mistake by Ricky there. He saw the hero. He's like, oh hey, there's a Beastmaster. I think the only skills that are similar do something like they set HP based on a percentage. So like
that.
There's some other examples, but I think there's nothing else like HP removal. They're trying to make it less confusing, basically the mechanics of Dota.
I was against it when it first came out. I was a big fan of like composite damage and universal damage and stuff like that, which I think still exists. But
No, it doesn't.
It's used to.
It's magic damage that pierces, or pure damage that pierces spell immunity. So universal is not.
Okay, gotcha.
So it's all about whether or not it pierces spell immunity. The special link.
So
if
yeah,
you highlight over a spell,
yeah,
you'll
exactly.
See it.
It's pure magical spell immunity piercing, or the one other set percentage that you were talking about.
The more you know about Dota, guy.
Yeah, we're really going in depth with the mechanics.
Yes, and kill.
That duel was forever away. Can they get it done? Tricks of the trade. I don't think they're gonna get the kill.
Oh wow.
They get the kill, but they don't get the duel victory, is what I should say. Ice blast. They do get. That pressed the attack as he was torrented up in the air. That was pretty nice. I don't know if he would have died regardless, but that was still pretty cool to see. And they smoke right after, and they're looking for another target down bottom. Anti-mage, it's hard to bring him down, but they have a couple of supports in the tree lines. They did deward. Pylai Dai has been scouted, but so too have the rest of them. They're going to go for a Burrow Strike. Pylai Dai in trouble. Epicenter getting channeled. There's smoke screen and Pylai Dai. They do use Epicenter for the kill, but a kill is a kill nonetheless.
And that means that anti-mage can't stay in the lane as much. They're doing a great job putting pressure down here. Even Cinderin, he's been farming like all game. He's got 31 CS here. And they're just prioritizing it. I think they're looking at their heroes and they're saying, look, they have easily better carry potential than us. We need to make sure that we're getting a lot of value out of our map. The only person that's not really ever farming is just Yapzor, trying to make space on Ricky, but everybody else is farming. They're going to hit this like crazy strong mid-game timing, and if they can overpower KP there, then they should be able to win the game.
Shadowblade has been picked up for the Slark himself. He'll continue to just farm away, as this is where it gets interesting. We've passed that early stage of the game where it's a lot of roaming and ganking. Now we're going to start seeing some items coming out. Blink Dagger for the Kezu Sand King should be soon. In fact, 100 gold away. But Pylai Dai and the rest of the crew will go ahead and smoke up and look for the enemy jungle. Slark would be a beautiful takedown if they can get it. But with Shadowblade and Shadow Dance up and ready to go, it's going to be tough. Mention some reinforcements. Do they have detection on Kaipi's side? And the answer to that question is one sentry and dust coming out from Bambo.
It's not a lot, but it's enough where if they find Ricky right now, they can get a kill. But in the meantime, Sing Sing might actually die.
He is playing very far back, though. They are completely missing off the map, and I think he knows that something is up here. Some smart game sense unless he walks up. It looks like they won't find anything unless they really want to dive this tower.
I think they're looking for the Slark right now, but Slark just got a Shadowblade a little earlier than usual. If they land a pounce on Sing Sing, he dies 100% in this game.
They're gonna go for it right now. Here comes Arrow. He's out, and there's gonna be the smoke screen as well. The Dark Pact, and guess what? Liv comes in and throws in the overwhelming odds. It's like, I'll take that kill. Now let me get that real quick. That's my Blink Dagger, guys. Don't worry about it. Very big item for London this game.
Really is. Now that it comes out, all the kills on AIM are going to be much easier, and that's really the nice thing about it.
Courier is flying to... No, stay there, Absor, please. Oh, okay, it's gone.
It's hard for him to kill couriers anyways. He only has 1 point in his passive. There's no way he'd get it.
X-Marks, really Era, in trouble. Shadow Dance will come. The Ice Blast on top, and they knew the Shadow Dance would be there. He can't heal up. He's going to shatter. Pyrolidite gets the kill. Big pickup. Now they're looking for Sidoran. They're going to continue onward here. They've blinked in. They've got Meta Void at the ready, but they're going to turn their attention elsewhere. The Absor is now in. Detection, not there. Kezu, Burrow Strike comes in. Epicenter, but the Roar comes out. Not being channeled anymore. The Tor aren't going to come through. Ghost Ship already used, I believe. Now the Tricks of the Trade. Kezu gets pressed the attack. I think it's time to leave if you're escape, but they're going to have the X marks on the Kezu. 3-3. Now there's going to be more damage from Yap, so they're going to jump in. There's the duel. Will they bring him down? The Torrent might save his life. The winner will go, but Kezu still has Fallen Sindarin looking for Sing Sing, but now Sing Sing looking to clean up. Limp and Yap, so trying to hightail it out. Limp slowed up the board, doing so much work with the overwhelming odds. Great Torrent. Fire Blast coming out. Can they get the job done on anybody? Sindarin might sacrifice himself away. The Mana Boy, not enough. He's barely alive at 100 HP. And here comes Arrow. He wants more. TP's coming through. Bambo will not make it. He will go down, but the TP is successful, at least for Pyrolidite. What a crazy engagement. Who won that fight? Because Arrow was dead, and so was Kizu.
I think it was Escape. I mean, Arrow did die at the start, but I think that Escape is getting more value out of their heroes right now. These really long engagements, you can see how clear it is. Like, IP is easily better if they start the fight, do an X combo with an AA Ice Blast, but after that it gets tough, especially because it was early here and they were limited on detection. So basically, Yapzar got to do whatever he wanted there, but they can always back each other up. They have Bloodlust on all their heroes, they can cast press the attack on whoever gets low, use bottle charges, that kind of a thing. Escape's looking really strong in these early engagements, and if the next fight is Escape going in first, I feel like they're just going to take a 5-0 kind of a thing.
Yeah, so we'll take care of a Hawk. If you're an Escape fan, I think you're a bit concerned about how Bone 7 is progressing in his farm. He's top of the net worth right now.
And you're worried. I'm sorry. Continue. My bad.
So Bone 7 at this point in time with the Battle Fury, 7,300 net worth, top in that net worth chart. That's the one factor that you're worried about. And it usually is when you're playing against an AM, regardless of the team and regardless of how far ahead you are, unless you're absolutely stomping the game. That AM is always just going to come in and direct you, I think, at some point.
He is doing well, but he doesn't have Manta yet, and he doesn't have any kills. He just has assists. So, and they have really good solutions. It's all can be dual, basically. An Ice Blast, the Absor's gonna get.
Oh my god.
Touch from it.
That is the sketchiest Ricky.
He wants to split this experience 5 ways instead of 4. It's actually not that valuable, but
yeah,
the important thing
is that.
Not much.
Does it change? Okay.
But the important thing is that it's a difference of, you know, it's everybody gets 20% instead of 25. It's really not much.
Okay.
He will steal the courier at least.
See, there it is. And he's going for Bambo, which is not going to be successful. Cloak and Dagger is on cooldown now for 6 seconds as he's used Tricks of the Trade. Dust is up. Yeah, he'll get the courier, but he will die for it. Almost worth it, if not altogether worth it.
As long as they're not able to take Rosh off of a death like that, then it's no problem. Because that's 175 gold for 5 people. That's like almost a 1,000 gold gold swing compared to the maybe 400. Actually, they kind of got a lot out of that. They got 557 from the Ricky kill because there were 4 heroes there. And Ricky lost 269.
Oh, Pyrolidite.
But it's still good.
Although, they do have Ghost Ship coming in. Torrent's going to come out. Arrow. Oh, see
my
you
God.
Later, my lord. That's Pyrolidite coming in with another Great Ice Blast. 3 down, including Yapzor on that Ricky. And all of a sudden, it's starting to turn bad for Escape. Sindarin caught, and he might be the fourth to go down. Does not die to the cold feet, but he will die to the Anti-Mage. Getting a double kill is Bone 7 as they progress into the Tier 2 tower. That is a fight that turns everything on its head. That fight giving them 4. And the Anti-Mage now up to 9,000. His Yasha, done.
It basically came down to Bambo being on the high ground there. He landed a Torrent that Escape didn't expect. Guaranteed the Ice Blast follow-up, which guaranteed 2 deaths. Really nice play. And then they chased everybody down. So now things are looking pretty bad for Escape, actually. Anti-Mage is definitely in that terror position where he's way ahead in terms of farm from everybody on escape. And they've just been 5-manning. KP knows that if they start playing solo, Slark's going to get pickoffs, Legion's going to get pickoffs. They're just 5-manning. So the only way that Escape can take that advantage without just winning a 5v5 teamfight is they have to just out-farm them. They have to split up across the map. Nobody should ever die, and they should always have eyes on their opponents to make sure that no one goes down. Here's a good example. They can get Bambo.
Yeah, they have the smoke screen up. The pounce will come through. Urn. Ice Blast is going to come out. Ghost Ship Torrent. That might almost be enough to kill him if the Ghost Ship had hit. It would have, but
or if the smoke cloud wasn't there. Sing would have gotten the double star storm.
Ooh, Kezu. About a half second, maybe second late on that Burrow strike. A good try though.
It was really close. Almost a BKB on Limp as well on the bot lane, just pushing here. So we'll be trying to counteract the 5-man that Kaipi is doing a lot. Once he grabs that, at least they'll have to use Roar at least when he does a duel on somebody.
Yapzor dead unless he can get out of detection range, which he is.
Just a sentry.
No dust on the aim just yet. He doesn't have slots for it. It looks like he has the wind lace on top of his Yasha, or Yasha that's supposed to be coming out. He'll finish up his Mantis style very soon. In fact, he'll have enough for the ultimate orb, I think, after this this ancient stack. Yeah, there it is. This needs the recipe now. So Manta's going to be coming out soon, but there's that Echo Saber for the Slark. It's back and forth we go. I do feel as though, and I wonder if you feel the same way, that Limp is not having the impact that I feel like he should in this game.
I mean, that's very often the case for Legion Commander. That's kind of the way that I see it. And he has been pressured a lot in the laning stage. But it's mostly the fact that it's Legion Commander. He genuinely needs to have like a BKB before he feels comfortable dueling in a lot of cases. In pub games, it's possible. Thing might die here.
He's gonna get caught. Epicenter coming through. He's got the damage, the leap away, and there it is. And now here comes Bone 7. Looking for Kezu. Cold feet, not gonna latch. Ice Blast is actually doing plenty of damage to him, but he'll be able to get back to health later on down the road. Arrow was looking to come in from the backstab, but no. And decides against it again. Instead, he'll look for Sing Sing. That's the backstab he was looking for. I forgot Sing Sing was low. I thought he had TP'd out, but no. Arrow just stays with him and gets that kill. One way or another,
those wards behind towers are so important for reasons like this. You can see their movements better. You can see when it's safe for you to attack to go for kills. And they definitely have vulnerable heroes, especially AA. Highlight Eyes doing a good job not dying. Syndra might die here, though.
Ghost Ship, Ice Blast, Necro, yes. Roar onto Kezu, he's probably dead to the Necro, yes. Double kill coming out for 3-3. Some serious damage being dealt by the Necro with Inner Beast. And now Era. He's going to have to fight the Mantis-style Bone 7 who comes out of nowhere. Here comes the Shadow Dance. They don't have Ice Blast.
Can they duel?
BKB. They're looking for the duel. They'll have to settle for 3-3 right now. They should get the victory. Mana Void comes up from the high ground. Look at where Bone 7's positioned. And they will finally get another one. It's going to be another hero going down. That's the Slark. And Limp is also out of mana. If only he had Mana Void again. X marks back. The Torrent will connect. And Limp will fall. It's a double kill for Bone 7. My God. Kaipi are just coming together. It's just like this 21-minute mark again. They're coming together. They're finding these fights. They're turning it around. Seems like they've done that every game so far.
The big thing was that Legion didn't have his Blink Dagger to be able to grab the AM. He had to walk in. AM was able to blink away. If they get the duel off on AM instead of the Beastmaster, that whole fight completely changes. Less mana burn, possibly an AM kill, which would have been by far the highest net worth hero. That has to be their target in future fights.
Important that they kill him. Do you think Escape can take Roche, maybe with a medallion, or can they not
easily
take it yet?
I would say, like, Slark's not the best hero for it unless he wins a team fight and has stacks picked up, but Legion's quite good at physical damage. They could probably do it. And they've got Bloodlust as well. Bloodlust on, like, Legion and Slark, they'll kill it, definitely.
Wait and see if they head down that route, but there's
going to
be
the Defusal pick up on Ricky.
Yeah, exactly. And that's
it's more of a pub thing, though, but it's good.
What is it going to do this game? Slow, just general slows across the board.
Yeah.
Nothing really dispellable.
But it's important to have that kind of teamfight control. Like, just if he uses his ultimate, for example, all of a sudden everybody's getting hit way more damage, and they're getting mana burned for 20 mana. Quite good.
He becomes sort of a pseudo-core, not quite as strong as the rest of them, but there's a chase happening, but the Burrow Strike comes in out of two. No Epicenter to follow up, though he has it. The arrow come on through. They have the X marks.
Oh, wow,
that's just
landed.
Beautiful! What a combination! And the bug is just destroyed, squashed, blown up by water, I don't know, drowned, whatever you want to call it, he's dead. Radiant's Curve will fall again, though, and this time it looks like it was Arrow that did the job. So, that's at least something they're getting out of it.
Embo's been playing his Kunkko perfectly. Just, he's always on the ball. I thought he might not cast X in time, but he's absolutely ready for where Sand King would be.
Yapsu looking for Pilot die, but here comes the arrow, and Yapsu will fall to the axes in a couple of right clicks.
Good try, just didn't anticipate the arrow, and it's nighttime as well. If that was daytime, he probably would have had that kill. All he needed to do is press his ultimate, A would have gone down, he would have traded. It would have been pretty good.
I just don't know. I feel like they're you know, doing one step forward, two steps back every time for Escape Gaming. Does it feel the same way to you, Purge?
They're trying to make stuff happen, and they're missing some things just barely. Like, you know, Kezu dying to try to save Cinderin, huge mistake, obviously, but he thought he could get out in time with just the Burrow Strike, Sandstorm running. He had a 4-staff, he would have been fine. Dies there. Yapsor tries to get a solo kill. It was very, very close. And if he would have had it, it would have been completely worth it. And they do still keep getting couriers, but the scary part is the AM. Either way, the net worth is very even right now. They just need to fight a little bit better and not let Kaipi win these trades that well. And then they can easily win this game.
And Kezu and Yaps are going to walk right up into a ward. Moonlight Shadow will go, and Sexy Bambo is going to go ahead and X marks and go ship Yapsor. Good tricks of the trade will avoid it, and allows him to go into some Shadow Realm where he's actually invulnerable from all of those spells and abilities.
Oh, you're giving me some lore here. Ooh.
Well, that's made up. I don't know if he actually goes to the Shadow Realm. 3-3 caught with a Burrow Strike, and here comes Yapsor. Defusal Blade already used once. Might use another. In fact, he will. Ice Blast coming in. And look at the duel coming in, but look at the Ice Blast damage coming out. All of this damage coming through from Kaipi. Multiple sources, and they get a double kill for 3-3, and they might get him a triple. Or is it just going to be... Yes, it's a triple kill coming out from 3-3. The Necro units, as well as the boars, what have you. Four dead. Anti-Mage is not even there, and Escape lose everything with the exception of the Slark.
This is a huge mistake, actually, there, to group up that heavily. I mean, Limp is feeling behind. He felt like he needed the damage. He forgot to pop BKB before he dueled, though. And because of that, he took all of the stun, all of the magic damage. At least then Ice Blast would have hit. He would have had the debuff, but he wouldn't have gone down to half HP just to start the fight. Pop BKB at the end, but it was too late.
I'm
what a
feeling,
huge fight from.
I feel as though the more and more we go throughout the series, the more and more it looks like Kaipi just seems to be, and I don't want to say this too early, but it just seems like they have the better options, they have the better movement so far. Not to say that they're the better team, but they're playing better in this particular series. And sure, it might be a lot of Limp standing in for Koikva. I think the first game he looked great, but these last two games, this one included, it's just not been Escape's day so far with these two games.
A couple of things have just been off. Like Yapsor, for example, had a great early game, has been making space consistently, went for the Blink Strike skill build. I normally agree with this, but if you go Defusal Blade, it's absolutely the wrong thing. Because if he had maxed out Cloak Egger, he would have been hitting like 150% for more damage. That's like a double damage and a half. It's like God Strength, basically. Mm-hmm. Cloak and Dagger maxed out instead of Blink Strike. He didn't do that much damage to Beast there. Beast is tanky, he's got a Vlad's and a Necro and an Iron Talon, but he probably would have died there much earlier if it just would have been the different skill build. Like, little things like that super add up and lead to four heroes dying instead of Beastmaster dying, like, right at the start.
Alright, what do we got going on next? It's going to be Yapsor heading up towards this Anti-Mage, and without any other heroes nearby, I don't see him being able to take him down. Also, Aegis on Bone 7, so... There's not much they can do. They have to kill him twice. I do like what Kaipi are doing. They're invading the enemy jungle. They're going to drop some wards down, make it so that it's safe to push that tier 2 tower in the top lane. Maybe try to throw a ward down towards that tier 3 tower, tier 2 tower in the mid lane, so more vision coming out. And I guess you're resorting to split push at this point for Escape. You don't want to fight into the Aegis, although Yapsor, I was like, that's a little too close for cutting a group wave, but... He's just trying to get as much information as possible.
Yep, and eventually the enemy team does show. It's kind of nice that they smoked while they did that as well. But they're going high ground.
Yeah, and they have the Aegis, and it's the perfect time. Bone 7 has a BKB, newly minted, no charges used just yet. Arrows fishing, looking for something. It'll find Kezu in the back line, but he's too far away. Although the illusions could do some nice damage and steal some of his mana. If Bone 7 wanted to blink forward and actually just mana void him, it was a possibility, although a bit ballsy. And while Backlash coming out from Cinderin as he takes the damage from killing the warrior, the Necro warrior. Remember, Aatrox is going to go down, and they're not going to contest this. I feel like they just can't do anything about this. Burrowstrike will finally come in again. He still has Aegis, and he's got reinforcements up the wazoo. Yapsor still has those five charges of Fusil Blade, and nobody is jumping in Epicenter, no duel. They get a free set of racks, and they just back up. That's it.
Crazy. Can't really do anything about that. It all came down to the smoke, basically. Escape was outmaneuvered there. They smoked four heroes on Kaipi. They move into enemy jungle. They didn't spot anybody. The Ricky just happened not to run into them because they went a different path. If he would have broken the smoke and died, then it would have been fine. Escape could have prepped that and actually set up and been ready to fight. But by the time they got there, especially with the arrow and the mana drain on Sanking, it delayed their ability to fight by like 15 seconds. So then the Rax goes down instantly, and now they get to pressure with the Aegis even longer.
Yeah, they're going
nowhere. The maneuver just changed so much. They thought it was just anti-mage split pushing and trying to take a free tower, but it was actually a five-man. And then it was too late at that point.
They also have a gem now on the Beastmaster. So if he doesn't have his Necro 3s up, well, then he's got his gem ready to go. Smoke up, Cinder and smoke immediately breaks. BKB, Limp wants to go right now. They want to try to fight this. The blink out from Bone 7, and Limp can't find a target. That BKB is going to wear off momentarily. Coming from the back is going to be Era. His Shadowblade is up. He still has his BKB, but... now with Limp's BKB down, this is going to be tough. This is a tough hold at the very least. They dropped the Observer Ward down. Bone 7 has the Mantis Owl ready to go. Not to mention the Basher. Not sure when he got that. I think he picked it up a little while ago. Desolator is up for Limp.
Good
pick. Provide them some extra damage, but I don't know if it's going to be enough.
It's going to help versus AM. I don't think it will do a huge amount
because
he's got so much armor. But
do not walk up there, Yapzor. You will be scattered by the Observer Ward.
It's the only way they win this.
Epicenter coming in. He's going to find two, maybe three. Look at that damage. Sing Sing, three down for the side of Kaipi, though. Bone 7 going to work. The BKB, Mana Void, Era, has to pop the Shadow Dance now. He wants more. He wants Bambo. He has to back away. Leap. Good double burrow strike. Bambo in trouble. And there's going to be Yapzor doing some work. Buyback coming in from a couple. They're all in now. And Bone 7 low. But again, it's just the Aegis. Three dead now for Escape. They buy back on the Ricky. And here comes Yapzor yet again. He wants Sing Sing. The burrow strike. Will they find Sing? Yes. He will go down twice. Down for 73. Yapzor gets roared up. That's a dieback for him. And Bone 7 finally loses the Aegis. And here comes the Slark with his own buyback, but still Bone 7 goes straight for that tier 3 tower. And what can Era do in response?
It's tough, man. They miscommunicated a little bit. Arrow backed off as soon as the Sand King went back in.
That's a style, and here we go. Era, Shadow Dance not available. He has to pounce away, go shift, and we'll see you later, Kenzu. He's got buyback. He might have to use it because guess what? Two sets of racks down. Luckily, there is a tier 2 bottom lane, but two sets of racks down against an anti-mage who you cannot kill. Sure, every other hero is killable in this game so far, but it's just anti-mage is running amok as he so often does, and Bone 7 is doing a great job of it. He goes with the Abyssal Blade on Era, out of mana. No stick charges the turret to secure the kill. That's gonna be Era dead for 84 after a buyback, and now they can do whatever they want on the side of Kaipi. And here we go. Bambo will blink right in, goes to the X marks, and Sin will get torrented up. Good Glimmer Cape and press the attack to fly through. Ice Blast will connect, however. Here comes Kezu looking to force in and blink for a Burrow Strike. He's not finding anybody. He has the Sandstorm. There's the Blink Strike from Yapzor, but now he might get caught. Tricks of the Trade will go. Now the BKB and the duel comes out, but the Roar to stop the damage. Bambo might actually live through this duel, and he will. He will eventually die, but it doesn't give any dual damage, and they bring down four of the heroes, and it might be five. Good game is called. Escape will go down 1-2 in this best of five series.
And Kaipi just played this game phenomenally. It looked pretty close in the mid game, but one fight after another, AM just kept wrecking, and Cape never got that team fight where they were able